गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न चैप्टर 8 ट्रिग्नोमेट्री सो लेट्स अंडरस्टैंड द मीनिंग ऑफ ट्रिग्नोमेट्री वर्ड इफ यू bifurcate यू कैन सी हियर वी हैव थ्री डिफरेंट वर्ड्स हियर ट्राई मीन्स थ्री गोना मीन्स साइड्स and metron means measurement. That means we are going to learn about measurement of three sides. Okay, how to find the ratios and their correlation with the angle. Okay, so we will study about triangle. Okay, and specifically we are going to learn about a right angle triangle. Okay, so let's recall what you have studied before about right angle triangle. You all know that side opposite to 90 degree is called as hypotenuse. Okay, and if I take any one angle here, I have mentioned here theta, so if I take any one angle which is not 90 degree, so just see the side opposite to it. I will write it as opposite side and one which is adjacent to it. So I can write in this way: adjacent, opposite and hypotenuse. I can define these three sides. Okay, so you have to remember one thing. First you identify what is hypotenuse, then identify what is opposite side. So obviously you will come to know what is adjacent. The left one is adjacent. Okay, so always try to identify opposite and hypotenuse. Okay, now let's see what are the different ratios that can be formed with these three sides. So I can have a ratio, if I have taken here triangle ABC, so I can have a ratio of AB upon AC, isn't it? Now AB means a side opposite to the respective angle. So here I have taken angle C whose measure is theta, so AB is opposite and AC is hypotenuse. So I have one ratio, opposite upon hypotenuse. And this ratio is called sine. Okay, so in trigonometry, opposite upon hypotenuse ratio is called as sine ratio of angle C. Because I have taken angle C, so I'll write here angle C, and it is written as sine AC. Sine, I will not write E here, I will write only SIN. Okay, but I will read it as sine only. Okay, sine C, or according to measurement, I can read it as sine theta also. Is it clear? Now let us move to the next ratio that I have. Another ratio I have, BC upon AC. Okay, so that means adjacent upon hypotenuse. So this ratio, which is adjacent upon hypotenuse, can be called as cosine. Okay, cosine ratio of angle C, and is written as cos. Okay, so I am going to write here cosine as cos of the given angle. So here my angle is C, so I will write cos C, or its measurement cos theta. Okay, so you have to remember that cos is adjacent upon hypotenuse. And third possibility I have here is AB upon BC. So AB upon BC means opposite upon adjacent. So this ratio, opposite upon adjacent, will be named as tangent ratio of the angle C, and in short I can write it as tan. Okay, so tan of angle C, that is tan theta. So we can summarize this as that in any right angle triangle, sine ratio is opposite upon hypotenuse, cos ratio is adjacent upon hypotenuse, and tan ratio is opposite upon adjacent. Okay, so ratio of these sides are named as sine, cos, tan, and these are called as trigonometric ratio. Okay, so let us summarize the same data as sine theta. So theta is one of the angles I have taken. You can take any letter A, B, C, theta, alpha, beta, whatever you want. So sine theta means opposite side of angle theta, which we have selected, upon hypotenuse. For cos theta, it is adjacent side of angle theta. So whatever angle we are selecting, with respect to that you have to decide whether it is opposite or adjacent. Okay, tan theta is opposite of angle theta upon adjacent side of angle theta. So you can write this as a formula. Okay, in short I will write it as opposite will be written like this, OPP. So to memorize this I can write like this, sine theta opposite upon hypotenuse, which I have written as hypo, cos theta is adjacent upon hypotenuse, and tan theta is opposite upon adjacent. So we are going to memorize this formula for our next exercise. Is it clear? So remember, opposite and adjacent, they must be correlated with the angle which we are taking. Okay, so let's apply this in exercise 8.1. So students, let's see first sum of practice at 8.1. As you can see here, in triangle PRQ, angle R is right angle, that is 90 degree. So with respect to this data, let us find out the following ratios. So I have here ratio sine P. So let's look at sine P. So with respect to this angle, opposite is given here. So I will write here opposite upon hypotenuse. So what is opposite of P? QR. So I can write here QR, and hypotenuse is always opposite to 90 degree, so it is PQ. Okay, so my required ratio is QR upon PQ. Okay, let's find out for cos P. So for cos it is adjacent upon hypotenuse. So let's write down the formula, adjacent upon hypotenuse. So what is adjacent? PR. So I will write here PR, and hypotenuse is PQ only. So this is my required ratio, cos P. Remember, I have to look at the angle which is required. For P, adjacent is PR, remember. For Q, adjacent is QR. So always remember, adjacent and opposite will be decided according to the required angle. Okay? Now tan P. So opposite upon adjacent, let's write down the formula. For tan, opposite upon adjacent. So what is opposite here? QR. And what is adjacent? PR. Okay. Now look at the fourth ratio. It is tan Q. Is it clear? Now tan means opposite. So I'll write here first formula, opposite upon adjacent. But this time, what is opposite of Q? PR. Remember, now I am talking about Q, so opposite is PR and adjacent is QR. Okay, so despite it is opposite upon adjacent, but they have two different ratios because here angle is different. So here opposite is with respect to P and here opposite is with respect to Q. So that is how you will write the ratios. Is it clear? So let's see problem number 2. Here we have a triangle XYZ where angle XYZ is 90 degree. Okay, and we have sides ABC. So length of sides is ABC. So write the following ratios. So now we are going to take reference of ABC. So according to this ratio, sine X. So sine means opposite. What is opposite here? YZ. So I will write here YZ upon what is hypotenuse? XZ. Now write down their values, their lengths. So YZ has length A. Okay. And XZ has length C. So my sine X ratio is A upon C. Okay. Because it is opposite upon hypotenuse. Now tan Z. I have to see tan Z. So opposite of Z is YX. So I will write here YX upon adjacent is YZ. Now what is YX? In figure it is given B and YZ is A. So my tan Z ratio is B upon A.
Okay. Now look at cos of x. What is cos ratio? Cos ratio is adjacent upon hypotenuse. So what is adjacent to x? Y x. So I will write here y x upon hypotenuse is x z. So my value of y x is b. For x z is c. So I'll write here b upon c. Okay. So you can see here for sin x and cos x the ratio is a upon c and b upon c. Now last one is tan x. So you have to look at angle x. Opposite of x is y z. Upon adjacent is yx. So remember, what is tan ratio? Opposite upon adjacent. Now write down the value. Yz is a and yx is b. So I got ratio here a upon b. Okay. So what is important here is in these two sums we have seen that you must know the formula. Sin theta opposite upon hypotenuse. See, the formula you should remember, opposite upon hypotenuse. Cos theta adjacent upon hypotenuse and tan theta opposite upon adjacent. So if you know the ratio, you can easily find the values. Okay, now we will see problem number 3. As you can see here, a right angle triangle is given, LMN, where angle LMN is 90 degree, angle L is 50 and angle N is 40 degree. So with respect to this data, let's find out the ratio. Now I have to find ratio sine 50. So sine 50, so I will write here sine means opposite upon hypotenuse. Let's write down the formula first. Okay. Cos means adjacent upon hypotenuse. Tan means opposite upon adjacent. Again cos means adjacent upon hypotenuse. Okay, so you have to remember one thing, that for a right angle triangle, hypotenuse is fixed. You cannot change that side. Okay, but adjacent and hypotenuse, adjacent and opposite, they can interchange with respect to the angle. For example, for 50 degree, MN is opposite side, LM is adjacent. Whereas for 40 degree, LM is opposite side and MN is adjacent. So you have to always identify opposite and adjacent with respect to the given angle. Okay, so for sine 50, what is opposite? MN. So I'll write here MN upon hypotenuse, that is LM. For 50, cos 50, what is adjacent? Adjacent is going to be LM. So I'll write here LM and adjacent will be obviously LN. Okay, now look at next ratio, it is tan 40. So 40 degree has opposite side LM, so I'll write here opposite LM, and what is adjacent to 40 degree? MN. So my ratio for tan 40 is LM upon MN. Now cos 40, what is cos theta? Adjacent upon hypotenuse, so adjacent to 40 is MN. So I'll write here MN upon hypotenuse, which is going to be LM in all the case. So if you know the formula, three formulas we are applying here, sine, cos and tan, you can easily write the ratios. Okay students, now we will see problem number 4. Here you can see in triangle PRS, PQ is perpendicular here. So we have angle PQR 90 degree, angle PQS 90 degree. Now in triangle PQS, you can see one of the angle as theta, it is given, angle QPS. Whereas in triangle PQR, angle PRQ is given as alpha. Okay, so theta and alpha. So the ratios which we have to find out in question, they are termed as alpha and theta, two angles. So I have to find sine cos tan for alpha and sine cos tan for theta. Okay, so let's see first angle alpha. Angle alpha is related to triangle PQR, isn't it? So whenever you are writing opposite and adjacent, it should be with respect to triangle PQR. You have to look at here. Okay, so let's write down sine alpha. So what is opposite of alpha? PQ. So I will write here PQ upon, what is hypotenuse for this triangle? It is PR. So you will write down PR, opposite upon hypotenuse. I am not writing formula now. Okay, now I am expecting that you have memorized the formula. Sine is opposite upon hypotenuse. Now cos alpha. Cos means adjacent. Adjacent is QR upon hypotenuse, that is PR. You can write QR or RQ, both are right. Tan alpha. Tan is opposite upon adjacent, that is PQ upon adjacent is QR. Okay, so these three ratios of sine, cos, tan, they are with respect to alpha. Now move to the next set, that is angle theta. So again you have to find sine, cos, tan. So look at angle theta. What is opposite of that? QS. So you will write here opposite side as QS. And what is hypotenuse for this triangle? PS. Is it clear? Now cos theta. Cos means adjacent upon hypotenuse, that is PQ upon PS. Okay, and tan theta, as you know, it is opposite upon adjacent. So what is opposite of theta? QS. Okay, and what is adjacent? PQ. So you will write QS upon PQ. So that is how you have found all the ratios. Okay, so students, watch the video carefully. And I will send the PDF also of all these sums. So you will copy down all the sums which are done here. Along with that, assignment will be sent to you. Okay? Thank you.